Some athletes like Colin Kaepernick, who really know a thing or two about trying to help people. He's donating $100,000 in coronavirus relief efforts and to black and brown communities. Okay, he says structural racism, as he puts it, is leaving people of color more likely to die of COVID. This is where we are. More than a month after two Utah Jazz players tested positive, setting off a chain reaction felt around the sports world unlike any in our lifetime. So we couldn't wait for this interview. We're very excited about having, Van and me are both excited about having Turner NBA sports analyst and legendary former NBA player Charles Barkley with us. Charles, thank you so much. Charles, we talk about a lot of different issues, but sports is unifying. And we're talking about how this, you know, this COVID-19 is affecting communities of color. But sports can, you know, reach across every demographic. But now, from the pros on down, nothing is being played. People aren't getting together. We don't have that unity among races and demographics and ages and everyone. What can you have? Did you ever imagine we'd be at this point right now?
I never thought in my lifetime we would be without sports. You know, I've been through 9/11. That's probably the worst thing I've been through in my life, but I never thought we could never play sports. You know, Van and DL, I got to tell you something. It's going to be a long time before things are normal. Even when we get back to playing sports, fans are not going to be allowed in the stadiums or the arenas.
You know,
is going to do a fantastic job looking out for the players and fans, but man, it's going to be a long time before fans are able to come to games again.
You know, you know my son. For kids, they love sports. It brings the country together. It also gives them something to shoot for. You got a lot of young people now feel like I'm missing my season. I don't know if I'm going to be able to play again. What would you say to young people who right now feel like they just have to sit home and play video games because they can't play the sports that they love? What advice do you have to the young people of America?
Well, you know, Van, I would tell these young kids what I've been saying for years, man. You know, a lot of people complain about college players not getting paid and things like that. I tell those guys, man, get that free education, because this thing is divided. You know, we talk about brown and black tonight because black people and Hispanics, we're the most vulnerable because of economics and systemic racism. But it really comes down to education and the type of job you have. So I would tell everybody out there in the black community, man, you got to make sure you get your education, you know, because we can talk about all we want to. This thing ain't working the same on everybody. It's really having a negative effect on the black community because of poverty and Hispanic community because of poverty and systematic racism. But if you're a young black kid and you get a chance to go to college for free, man, take advantage of that situation and make sure you're going to use the system and the system don't get to use you.
So I want to talk to you more about that. I'm glad you mentioned that, Charles, because you often talk about personal responsibility. But you've mentioned systematic racism at least twice in this conversation. And, you know, I talked about it with Dr. Regina Benjamin earlier because, we need to talk about urban planning. We need to be honest about food deserts. We need to talk about disparities in healthcare. We need to talk about how people got into the projects in neighborhoods, how they got set down in neighborhoods, in rural communities, and so on and so forth. It's not just, and it is a problem, eating bad foods or whatever. We need to take responsibility for that. But that's just not it. That's not the only factor.
Well, listen, I hate using the word systematic racism because then you give people a crutch. We, as black people, we have to accept the fact there is systematic racism, but that does not give you a reason to go out and be overweight, have diabetes. You know, we got to eat better.
Right.
We need better access to health care. We need better access to being able to work out and things like that. But unless we get better health care, which is part of the system, unless we learn to work out better and take better care of our bodies, we're always gonna be at a disadvantage. We can't go back and worry about history. History is what it is. Mm-hmm. But we are what we are. And this is going to be a wake-up call for us as a black community. Guys, we're not part of the system. But unfortunately, we're actually going to be in control of the system when this thing is over. Because the reason this thing y'all having tonight is important. Van, done. Who are the people who serve our food? Who are the people who work in the hotels? Who are the people who work in the supermarkets? There are black people and Latinos.
Right.
Yep. And when's the last time, and listen, I'm not bragging, it is what it is. I don't remember the last time I stayed in a hotel that didn't have a bunch of amazing black women and a lot of amazing Latino women working in those hotels. So that's why for America, we really need to take care of these people.
Van, real quick, but it's not just that, it's also poor people, because poor people have the same issues as people of color. Sorry, go on, Van. Sorry about that.
Well, you talked about the need to work out and stuff like that. Some people can't go to the gym, that kind of stuff. You look pretty good. Are you able to work out? What is your regimen right now at home?
Because I need to socially distance myself from my refrigerator, but go on.
You know,
what are you doing?
Van and DL, you know, guys, I had to make a conscious effort myself. I like to drink. I probably drink too much. So when this thing started, I made a conscious effort. I'm only drinking on the weekend. I'm only drinking on Friday and Saturday. I'm working out twice a day because I know for me personally, if I eat much as I want to, like I am, like a fat person, and I drink every day like I have been a casual drinker for 30, 40 years, I could be big as a house when this thing is over. So this to me, this was a wake up call to me. And like, cause first of all, every person has to look in the mirror. Like I can have a bunch of reasons why, excuses, but I had to look myself in the mirror and say, Charles, you cannot drink every day and you cannot eat anything that's not nailed down. That's my personal challenge.
That's me. But that's me on the food part, but I have to be honest, and it's probably going to disappoint a lot of people. I'm a fake drinker. Like, I carry the same drink. When I was drinking, I carry the same drink around. Everybody thinks I drink more. I haven't had a drink since, I think, New Year's. I did the dry January and then never went back, and I just don't have the desire, but everybody thought I drank more than I did because I would, like, carry the same drink around or just get sort of a refill. But I think during this time... Yes.
Hey, Dunn, people thought I drank a lot because I did.
But here's the thing. I noticed...
I had to check myself. Because
I want to talk about that.
Number one, this thing has been going on for over a month.
That's where I'm going to. A lot of people are going to either have to check into, they don't know if they're going to check into AA first, and I'm being honest, or Overeaters Anonymous, or deal with their mental health first because they're going stir crazy. Sorry, go on, Charles. Well,
but that goes back to you guys. You said it earlier. At the end of the day, it's all going to come down to personal responsibility. And I had to make my own choices. Like I say, there's nothing to do. I'm not going to sit around and play video games all day. I'm not going to sit at my house and drink alcohol every day. And I'm going to do something. I bought myself a bike. I've been riding a bike every day because, like I say, this is every person's going to have to look in the mirror and say, do I drink too much? Am I eating too much?
Yeah. I love because what you're saying. I love what you're saying because I think it's been a little bit of a false choice in this conversation that's been building in the black community. Is it the system's fault or is it individual black people in our culture's fault?
It's all of the above.
I know Don,
first of all, you've been fantastic for years. And I know you got some blowback from the black community. And Ben, you've been amazing in the whole political process. But anytime we say something about black people, we get blowback. And listen, right. I'm very proud to be black, always have and always will. But there is personal responsibility. I can't get fat and obese and then say to myself, it's because of systematic racism. I'm very aware of systematic racism, but I can't get fat and obese and then say, yeah, the system made me fat. It doesn't work like that. Let me tell you how I see it.
I think two things. One is it is true in our communities, you know, they got the bad food. They got food you can never find in a white community. In our community, the liquor stores, all that type of stuff. And so that's the system part. But we have had black women in our community for years who have been telling us, hey, drink the healthy food, put down the bad, you know, wearing the head wraps. You know, we call them hoteps and push them off to the one side. It turns out that the hoteps in our community were correct, the ones telling us to eat to live and put down the sugary drinks. And so we don't have the resources in our community, but we can be resourceful. And there have been people in our community begging us for years to take it seriously. So I think this virus is trying to teach us about wellness and about oneness. And it's been there. We just haven't listened to it.
Okay, I agree with both of you. But listen, don't get me wrong. We have to agree. There are some fat white people out there, too. And who don't eat properly. But I also think that we happen to be in a position where we can do that. There are some people who don't have the information that we have. There are some people who were set down in quote unquote ghettos and they don't get the information. And sadly, they don't have access to that. They live in food ghettos. So I don't want to be hard on everyone and I don't want to blame people, but I'm here to educate people. So yes, I would like people to be able to lift themselves up.